My name is Zanwa Kibendiala from University of Limpopo. The title of my postdoc is Understanding the Effects of Nickel Addiction on the Stability of Nutrients and Cardiac System Using this Differential Field Approach. This work has been supervised by Dr. Aramudiva, Professor P. Imoto, and Professor Peter Stauge. We chose to study adrenal cardium because of its high metastatic transformation from B2 to B19 at 1883. Other exists as high temperature phase, which is the austenite phase, which has a cubic B2, while at low temperature is known as the martensite thrombic B19 structure. So the main challenge is that B2 adrenal cardium was found to be elastical unstable due to negative prime. So we are trying to improve this phase by the addition of nickel. The method used to address this problem is density functional theory. So here we're showing the atomic arrangement of titanium, palladium, nickel. So titanium-based semi-metal alloys are applicable at low temperature, 173 Kelvin in visors and medical stent. At high temperature, they are applicable in automotive and aerospace industries as actuators. So available actuators, they are made up of titanium nickel operating at temperature of 373 Kelvin. Now there is a need of actuators operating at temperature above 373 Kelvin in Boeing variable geometry chevron. So titanium palladium nickel play an important role in actuator application. Calculations are based on this functional theory as implemented in VASP code. We use VASP code because of its robustness in determining graphic properties. So the exact correlation was treated with DGA PBE, which enabled us to approximate material good as compared to experimental. So we used sufficient size to substitute palladium with nickel. Afterwards, we did geometry optimization, and these properties were calculated as a PC with 48 compounds. Firstly, on the results and discussion, we checked the structural properties by looking into lattice parameters. We found that the lattice parameters increase with the increase in nickel composition. This is attributed to the fact that nickel has got small atomic radius as compared to palladium. Furthermore, we checked the thermodynamic properties by looking into heat of formation, where you found that the heat of formation increases with the increase in nickel, which suggests that the thermodynamic stability is not enhanced. We also checked the electronic properties by looking into density of state, where you find that the electronic stability is not enhanced in this case with the addition of nickel. Furthermore, we check the elastic properties to check the strength of the material by looking into the elastic constant and energy ratio. So in order for material to be regarded as mechanical stable, there are certain conditions which needs to be satisfied. So we observed that each titanium palladium nickel is mechanically stable above 43% of nickel. We also found that titanium palladium nickel show anisotropic behavior for the entire composition range. Lastly, we checked the hardness and ductility. We found that 6.25% of nickel appears to be the hardest as compared to other composition. Furthermore, She and Yang indicated that the structure is less compressible and stiffer above 18.75%. So in terms of ductility, we looked into power and poison. So power needs to be greater than 1.5, while poison has to be greater than 0.26. But we found that the material is ductile except for 6.25 and 18.5% of nickel. According to power, in the case of poison, is ductile throughout. In conclusion, we could say using ab initio DFT approach, we successfully studied the semi-metal alloys properties of titanium palladium alloys. This system was found to be mechanically stable above 43% of nickel. It was also revealed that increasing nickel above 18.5 could effectively improve the ductility of the material. Here are the reference we have used in this study. I would like to acknowledge CHPC, TICOP, CSIR, and University of Limpopo. Thank you so much.